good.
Amy, has she been head shy since you got her?
And then, you know, eventually the stroking of the ears actually feels good, particularly if you kind of can pull on them a little bit, mm-hmm. just like it would for you. Mm-hmm. She's not ready for that. Mm-hmm. But when you get to where you can really fully stroke her ears and kind of even have a little sort of milking motion, then you'll be able to start getting on the inside of that ear. She's not ready for that. She can't. She's trying real hard to tolerate just touching. Here comes another horse. Come here. Hello. She's distracted. She's forgetting I'm touching her. That's a good girl. Yeah. That's more pressure than she's tolerated because mm-hmm. she's just distracted. She mm-hmm. forgot to think it hurt. Mm-hmm.
My question with her has always been, is does it hurt?
No.
It doesn't hurt, it's just no, she's it's just
her,
scared.
It's her bag, it's her memory mm-hmm. that it's gonna hurt. But also, you know, she throws her head up, shakes mm-hmm. it, and then the pressure goes away. So that's a reward, that's a release of pressure. Mm-hmm. So she thinks that's the right thing to do. Horses are superstitious too. They create these. Lucy's got the most superstitious horse in the world. Also a Palomino.
Also not being prejudiced, but
also a head shy. Also a ranch broke.
Of course, he's got a brand on his cheek.
Yeah.
You know, I don't think she actually was ranch broke. She was.
Oh, I was thinking of Jerry's horse.
Yeah, she was broke in a reining barn in Minnesota.
And when you know, when she gets to where she'll tolerate pressure, also it feels very good mm-hmm. to be massaged.
And she'll let me do that. She'll let me do that, no problem. I can go all the way up through the middle, up over a pole, and you know. Down her fetlock and stuff, it's just mm-hmm. when I get anywhere near the ears.
Mm-hmm. But anytime she drops her head, take the pressure away, because that's a far better response
okay.
than throwing the head up in the air. Good girl. I bet you she's been twitched in the ears.
Is that done, like, for training or doctoring?
Doctor. But it just sort of makes them forever ear shy.
Who still does so, that?
Particularly when you go to this motion, mm-hmm. that's like grabbing the ear. Yeah, and particularly when horses are, when it's this approach, they don't like. But she's shy on both ears. A lot of times a ear, one that's been twitched in the ear will only be ear shy on the left ear.
Mm-hmm. No, it's her right. As far as my experience with her has been, the more sensitive one.
Her right.
Mm-hmm.
Who knows? It doesn't really matter.
When I first started riding her, I rode her with a head stall that had a band going across, and mm-hmm. it was harder to get over her ears.
Mm-hmm.
And that was like, I mean. She'd freak out at me putting the bridle up on her over her ears. Mm-hmm. And this is really easy with that one ear. I can just pop it on real quick.
Mm-hmm. That's a good girl. No. you know, it won't take long, just a little 5-10 minutes every day.
Taking that time, yeah.
Eventually she'll get to where, that actually kind of feels good. Mm-hmm. But you can clip her bridle path without any problem?
No, when I first started doing it, it took me a long time and I had to just stand there with the clippers and work my way up her neck really slowly until I got here. And then once she figured out I wasn't going to hurt her with it, now it doesn't take me, you know, she'll maybe throw her head once and then put it down.
So now it's just touching the ears.
Mm-hmm. It's the ears.
Mm-hmm. Like I said, stay on the outside.
I mean, I've never gotten that far without protest.
It shouldn't be hard to train a horse something that's easier than what they were doing.
Mm-hmm. And, it's just having the right tools.
It's just releasing at the right moment. So every time she's thrown her head in there, she's gotten a release. That's a good girl. She's starting to get where she kind of likes it now. But every time I touch a new place, we go right back.
Yeah.
Good girl. But that's what, you know, that's what advance and retreat is. You just advance so far as causes the horse discomfort and then hold that ground. So now it's like right over here. So I just go so far, hold that ground. She's not resisting, but I'm still not going to go farther because this, that's the point that she didn't like. So now this base every year, she doesn't mind me touching anymore.
Mm-hmm.
But when I get higher up, oops, she'd make a liar out of me. And then the whole thing starts over again on the other side. You'll be clear back to here, which is where
we train the other side of
where
brain.
We started, mm-hmm. And then here and then here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And she'll like, you know, I may have her pretty far today, but tomorrow you might start clear back here again. But it should get better. You should be able to advance farther every day.
Do you want to achieve perfection on one side before you start on the other side?
Yeah, you want to work on one side at a time when you're doing something new with a horse. Going side to side would be the last thing you'd do. And I'm not sure you'd really ever want to go side. You're not trying to challenge, you're not trying to make it hard. You know, but like if you were teaching a horse a side pass, let's say, work all on one side, go do something else, come back, work all on the other side. And only when the horse is finished in that skill would you go from right to left to right to left. So from here, I would start trying to get my thumb on the inside and sort of doing like that. Once you can totally stroke the outside of the ear. So see how when she starts fidgeting, I just hold still. I don't retreat, because that would teach her, that would reward her. But just hold still and release when she takes it. And the reason I've got my hand here is to protect my head.
Okay.
So if she slings towards me, that's the voice of experience speaking. I don't want to be bashed in the head. Because I'm not really trying to hold her still, because it needs to be her choice to move or not, but she needs to learn the only way the pressure's going to go away is when she holds still and or lowers her head. with her when she moves.
Mm-hmm.
It's not about anything else but touching her ear. Nothing else matters. Sometimes, like, they'll move and drop their head, so you have to release it. And then they don't know if the moving caused the release or the drop in the head. So then at some point you have to only release when they drop the head. But they figure it out. So the licking and chewing means that she's relaxed enough for salivation to start again. So when they start, then she's just moving the saliva around her mouth. So just like us, when they get frightened or nervous, salivation stops. They get the dry mouth. And then when it starts again, they start moving that saliva around. What a good girl you are.
The parasympathetic nervous system getting stimulated and relaxing.
Yeah, just like that.
Mm-hmm.
I'll take your word.
Yeah,
exactly. Exactly, and the breathing too, you know, when she...
I knew the licking and chewing was always a sign of relaxation. I didn't know why, though.
Mm-hmm. Mm. All right, so I think you can get her over this. Just got to put a little effort into it.
Julie, why do some people say that the licking and chewing means the horse is thinking? Is that just bad information?
Well, I don't, for centuries and maybe millenniums, we've known licking and chewing was a good sign. And in a way, it does mean they're thinking. So their mind is back in order. If they've relaxed, no horse, no person can really think things through when they're scared. So it does mean they're relaxing. It does mean that maybe they're thinking again. But the mechanics of it is salivation. The physiology of it is salivation has begun again. Now maybe it's begun again because they're thinking or because they're relaxed enough to think. So now she's okay, clear to hear. But when I get beyond that, she is resistant. So anytime you hold ground, it's just money in the bank. So we don't feel like you have to advance it. I mean, I've advanced her pretty far just because it's kind of fun. But anytime she lowers, I'd give her a release because that's a good result. But you can kind of see how when she lowers, she knows that's what's getting me to take my hand away. And so this would work if a horse was afraid of the water hose or fly spray or clippers or anything. As soon as they feel a sense of control over it, the fear goes away. But just the fact that I've got my arm on top of her neck, I could hardly reach her ears when we started.
Just the fact that her head's down.
Yeah.
Even,
And it's hard, She's convinced herself this hurts. And at some point it did. Or it scared her. Even if it didn't. Sometimes just the fear of something is as bad as the something actually happening.
Her head tossing in the saddle be at all related to thinking that pressure gets her away from being here?
Yeah, sure, because it becomes the habitual response to everything you don't want. Although sometimes her head tossing is it's a gesture more than a reaction, and it's a defiant gesture. Mm-hmm.
And then she did
when the nose goes in a circular motion, that's a gesture of defiance.
She did it a few times when T and I finished yesterday, where she was totally relaxed and did that like electric jolt. It wasn't the
toss yeah, that
see,
way.
Yeah, see, that I don't a, think is, like I this. Think that's a, and they call it head shake, and it's not really fully understood. It seems to be UV related, so like horses that do it a lot outside won't do it inside. There's evidence it's allergy related, like I was telling you, the two horses I have that do it only do it in the spring, just for a short time, 2-3 weeks, and then they stop. Also, if they're doing it like when you're not even riding them, you know, they're not even tacked up, that tells you something.
I was just curious about Dale talking about adjusting the pole if her ears were shy too. If something happened and she did do something to that part of her head.
Yeah, it doesn't take much to bug in her ear now. It doesn't take much for the pole to get out of adjustment. And then, you know, then you've got, you know, maybe some neurological stuff going on. So.
I'm trying to, I had her chiropracted in, well, it's probably been 5 or 6 months now. And there wasn't anything real significant that he felt going on with her.
Did he adjust up there, though?
He did, and in the same way that Julie's doing, pretty quickly she was like, oh, this feels kind of nice. I mean, right. It was almost like she was under a trance working with him.
Thank you for being our extra video while we wait for the landscapers.
Oh, is that what we're waiting for?